Monday, armed gunmen stormed Tripoli's oil corporation's HQ. Tuesday, Tripoli's international airport is targeted by missiles, but reopens the next day, just a week after the UN announced a ceasefire. Violence by rival militias is the new normal in present-day Libya. September 11th, 2012. The violent attack on the US consulate in Benghazi was when the world woke up to Libya's security problem. Ambassador Chris Stevens tried to warn the Obama administration of Libya's descent into chaos. The warnings did not save his life. Joel Rubin worked closely with Stevens at the State Department.
We overestimated how quickly Libyan society would recover from the invasion, from essentially deposing Gaddafi. And Chris Stevens, the ambassador, was fighting against that mentality, which is that the United States should not be in the business of regime change and reconstructing countries.
In the heady days of the Arab Spring, hopes for a post-Gaddafi democratic Libya were high. NATO allies announced Benghazi's liberation after giving rebels sustained air cover. But in the years that followed,
we just didn't dedicate enough resources to the reconstruction of Libya. And in many ways, it laid the groundwork for what we now see, which is terrorist organizations taking advantage of open spaces not controlled by governments to train, to get organized, and to even get into the Gaddafi weapons caches, which were plentiful.
And where there's a security vacuum, enter ISIS.
We are conducting strikes in support of government-aligned forces as they fight to retake Sirte from ISIL, and we will continue to support the government's efforts to secure their country.
ISIS fighters fleeing Syria first went east to Dernan, and then west to Sirte. Failing to establish another caliphate, they fragmented and bled into Libya's desert terrain, now capitalizing on its porous borders with Egypt and Tunisia. Libya expert Karim Mazan.
The Egyptians are trying to do the same, but for some reasons, they have not been able to seal the border. It's thousands of miles of desert, open land.
Libya has three rival governments, divided between Tripoli and Tobruk. France and the UN are trying to bring them together. So did the Paris summit actually achieve anything?
No.
Each have rival armies. General Khalifa Haftar's forces defend Tobruk's House of Representatives, but competing militias stand for Tripoli's government of national accord. The continuing violence is the catalyst for migration and human smuggling on a massive scale. The UN-backed government of national accord is anything but.
So far, the UN has failed in Libya. I think it's sometimes worth just calling a spade a spade.
So what should the US do next?
What we have to recognize is that this notion of claiming we have created a national unity government, when it is divided internally, has very little sway over militias and very little physical military capacity to impose its will, and only very modest amounts of economic power at its fingertips.
Gaddafi's Libya relied on its oil crescent to prosper, but Haftar's army controls the ports. These days, arms and people are Tripoli's main currency. Nina Larsen, I-24 News,